basically, I don't know if you've gone through an MRI scan, but when you go in through an MRI scan, anything that is the least bit ferrous, you have to take out. If you had keys in your pocket, it would fly out of your pocket and get stuck to this really big magnet that's rotating around you.
As we're implanting younger and younger children, we all at some stage in our life will require, for different reasons, to have an MRI scan to diagnose a problem. The main issue we had with cochlear implants initially is that MRI scans were contraindicated because part of the cochlear implant has got a magnet. However, things have developed over the past few years. So more recently, we're getting implants that have got MRI-compatible magnets, and the technology have even changed recently where you don't even have to apply a bandage to the patient's head to have an MRI scan.
What the current Ultra 3D does is, I guess the best way to describe it is to divide and conquer. So what they did was have lots of little magnets that are able to rotate freely, and that allows these magnets to orient to the MRI scanner beam when it happens. And then once that's done, they're flicked back and they're able to contact. So it's a very elegant way of doing it. And if I were a parent having to make the choice for a child, all things being equal, you know, you would obviously go for a scan, an implant that was MRI compatible rather than one that's not.